evening, everyone. Welcome to our annual holiday concert. I'd like to take a moment to welcome you all here. Thank you all for coming out so very, very close to the holidays. I'm sure all of you are done shopping and done wrapping and done cleaning. And why are you laughing? If you're anything like me, you've not even started yet. And that's okay, because as I do every year, I promise I'm going to get you out of here in under an hour. And fortunately for people like us, the good people at Target and Walmart are open late, so we'll be fine. Our soloist on our opening, on trombone, senior field leader, J.J. Brenson. Trumpet soloists, seniors, Jaden Jones and Matt Tinkman. And in order to get us out of here in time to finish or start, in my case, our Christmas shopping, our holiday shopping, we're going to keep things moving. We're going to feature Matthew and Jaden one more time on trumpet, and joining them on trumpet will be Richard Zayas. We're also going to feature Kaylin Williams on drum set. And I'd like to invite out our color guard captains for this next piece. Joining us out here in front, Tanisha and Taisha Saunders, and Terezina Sago Reyes. I cannot say enough wonderful things about our color guard. They do all their own choreography. They work out all their own routines. With Mrs. Thompson, our color guard advisor, they just do a fantastic job. So we're going to feature them along with our three trumpet soloists and the rest of our trumpet line on Hark the Herald Trumpet Swing.
Thank you.
One more round of applause, please, for our panel. And certainly, for Mrs. Trish Monson and all the work that she does with them as well. Please, thank her. Our next selection is one of my favorites, and for most of our students, I think it's one of their favorites, and I hope it'll be one of yours. This is Selections from Frozen. We're going to feature on drum set Mr. Christopher Stevens. Thank you. I cannot say enough wonderful things about the young people who are on stage with me, and I will say plenty of wonderful things about them a little later on tonight. However, I would be remiss if I did not mention the folks that are working in our theater programs, that are continually building the foundation upon which we stand, building the success that we are able to enjoy. Certainly need to thank Rachel McKeel, who's over at Bailey Middle School. She's here this evening for all the work she's doing. I have to thank Matt Whitley for all the work he's doing over at Kerrigan with our beginning band. And it is truly an honor and a pleasure to be able to introduce this next individual. And before I do that, I also have to thank him profusely. He has been here in West Haven since 1995. He has worked in our elementary school program. He is now director of bands in our intermediate school program. His work for the past 20 years or more has built our theater program. This year alone, his commitment to recruiting single-handedly built the largest band that any school in West Haven has ever seen, ever. He recruited over 350 students for our Kerrigan Intermediate School band. His work is directly responsible for our success and has continually been responsible for our success and hopefully will continue to be responsible for our success. Not that I want to put any undue pressure on him, but it is truly an honor and a pleasure to have him as a colleague and to call him my friend. I would like to turn the program over to Mr. Angelo Vesicchio for our next song.
First of all, I don't know how Miss Marcella remembers all these names. She's been rattling off names all night. I can barely remember mine when I wake up in the morning. But thank you so much. Actually, it's because of you as parents that the program has become so successful. If it's not for you guys renting those instruments, it's a financial burden. Thank you so much. We do have 340 students this year, and I hope a lot of them continue. And again, thank you for the opportunity of guest conducting. A good handful of students, I did start in this band. This is my second time conducting them. I was here in May. They're amazing. They're just so easy to work with, and it's always a pleasure. Have a great holiday, everybody. Thank you for having me. And without any further ado, Feliz Navidad.
Thank you.
One more round of applause, please. On drum set on that last piece was Christopher Skeens, Caitlin Williams is going to after Christopher Skeens on one side. Caitlin Williams is going to join us on drum set for this next piece, and we're going to feature Mr. Brandon Moore on mallet percussion. This is Mariah Carey's All I Want for Christmas Is You. Time and time again, but not just for me. They work hard for me in rehearsal, They work hard for me in the classroom. They work hard for me on the field, off the field. But they work hard for their teachers, in the classroom and out of the classroom. They work hard for their coaches. They work hard for the community. And for that, they should be commended. And I just want to recognize some of our students who not only were able to keep up with our intense schedule this fall, but several other schedules as well. We have with us members of our girls' soccer team who worked very hard this season, including senior Eliza Barberi. Please stand, all of our girls' soccer team. Stay standing. And I'm gonna have to stay up there because I want you to see something when I get to the end. Also, working very hard this fall, members of our cross country team, including senior band president and captain Paige Sheridan. Cross country team. Senior captain Serena Fasora. Members of our girls volleyball team, including senior Marilyn Tran and captain and office manager and my right arm and my emotional support and captain senior Devin Pasdale. Please young lady who's already standing, Miss Anna Bartosi, who is also a member of our wonderful dance team, who had a great fall with us under the direction of their coach and band alumnus, Liz Petrakis. Give another nice round of applause. These are our fall athletes, and you'll see many of them and several more are in the spring when I introduce them as well. You guys can grab a seat. I am going to talk a little bit longer because I also have to recognize some other people who had a wonderful fall. Members of our girls' varsity cheerleading squad, who I believe are here this evening. They cut their practice short so they could be here. They competed in regionals a couple of weeks ago, took first place in both of their divisions, and will be representing West Haven High School at Nationals in Florida with my dear friend and my partner in crime, their coach, Angie Alston. Other people out there with us this fall. Right, the team. They did all right. I have with us on stage three gentlemen I'd like to introduce. Two of them played freshman ball this year in our saxophone section, Eliza Estrada and Terrell Williams. In our percussion section, his hard work paid off and he was suited up with the big boys this season on Friday night with our varsity squad, Daniel Camaros. If you go back to my time here in high school, I've had 26 seasons with this team. All are exciting, all are wonderful. None have ever been as magical as this season. This team was passionate, this team was exciting, this team was a perfect 10-0. This team was the Sodom and Bowl winners, this team was the SEC Division champions. This team had members representing West Haven High School in the Levi Jackson team, the SEC All-Area team, the Walter Camp All-Area team, the Class LL Coaches All-State team, and the New Haven Register All-Area and All-State team. And our own head coach, Rich Boucher, is the SEC Coach of the Year. I cannot say enough wonderful things about these people. We are honored and blessed to have been a part of this, to continue to be a part of it. We are truly fortunate for the support we have from our athletic department, from our coaching staff, from our athletes. I have colleagues in several other districts who would describe their relationship with their coaches and their athletic department as good, and I can assure you they have nothing compared to what we have. So I cannot thank you enough, I cannot commend you enough, I cannot say enough wonderful things about how great an experience it was for us to be a part of that. We look forward to the future. Please give all of these folks a round of applause for them. We're going to keep things moving with another crowd favorite and alumni favorite. I'm sure my alums are out there and they'll remember this. This is Selections from the Nightmare Before Christmas. I'd like to invite up our band parent president, Hillary Brinson, and at this point we're going to draw the 50-50 raffle and a couple of other raffle baskets. I would like to take this time to thank our Band Parents Association and our executive board and everyone who's helped out behind the scenes and all fall along with our 50-50 raffles and our socials and feeding the kids and helping us with uniforms and helping us with funding. They do a tremendous amount of work behind the scenes. A lot of it I probably don't even know is happening. So please give them a round of applause, especially Mrs. Brinson for all the support. I'm going to hand her the microphone because I don't want any responsibility for this money or anything else here. Mrs. Brinson has asked me to tell everyone who has entered into the mailbox raffle that that raffle will be drawn in the spring. I don't know what that means, but I imagine someone out there does, so there you go. Thank you, Lori. It gives me great pleasure to introduce our next guest. He's an alumnus from West Haven High School and from our West Haven High School band. After high school, he went on to join the Army National Guard, where he still serves our country as Staff Sergeant. He then went to Southern Connecticut State University to get his degree in elementary education. So not only was I proud to call him a former student, but now a colleague. And he then went back to school and has recently received his degree in school counseling. So not only was he a colleague, but he was here in our building for the fall, and it was wonderful, wonderful to have him here in our school counseling office. As sad as we were to see him go, that's how excited Carrigan Intermediate School was to have him back in his sixth grade classroom. It gives me great pleasure to introduce my friend, Lenny Adams, for the narration of the Christmas story.
You told me to dress appropriately.
That's appropriate, all right. And to think Angela was worried about what he was going to wear tonight.
I'm not as pretty as he is.
This next piece is really cool. I think it's my new favorite piece to do. It tells the tale of Krampus, the legend of Krampus. Krampus is sort of the antithesis of Santa Claus, as Santa Claus visits the homes of all the good boys and girls to bring gifts. Krampus visits the home of those who maybe weren't so good and takes them away. So, parents, there's that.
You've been warned.
I'm going to have a little talk with my niece about the Krampus later this evening, who promptly informed her mother the other day, she does not need Santa Claus to come to the house. Her grandmother will give her anything she wants. 3 years old, this one is, okay? And all my colleagues out here, get ready. She's coming through the West Haven school systems. This next piece is entitled The Christmas Tale, The Legend of Krampus. Thank you.
child on Christmas, you'll find the toys and the gifts that Saint Nick left behind. But if you've been a bad child, Saint Nick won't be there. Instead comes the Krampus, and then child.
Traumatized you here. Again, please, a round of applause for Lenny Adams for joining us. And please, also a round of applause for our percussion section because they're working their tails off. Very quickly, because I know I'm pushing the limit here with my hour under the wire that I gave you at the start of the night. Just some thank yous, because again, I get to stand here and enjoy all the applause and all the accolades, and really, I do very little of the work. They do most of the work, and behind the scenes, we have a team of people supporting us all the time. Starting first and foremost with Superintendent Cavallaro, Assistant Superintendent Drozdowski, and our coordinator Francine Coppola, Mayor O'Brien, all of our City Council members, and all of our Board of Education members for their continued support, not just for our program, but for our Fine Arts program, K-12. Please give them a round of applause. To our administration here, again, starting at the top with West Haven High School Principal and West Haven High School Band alum, Pamela Gardner. West Haven High School Vice Principal and West Haven High School Band alum, Dana Paredes. Our Vice Principals, John Della Cameron, Scott Shand, and Trish Rubles. All of our faculty and staff, our custodians, our secretaries, our administrative assistants, people who come out of the woodwork to help us anytime we need them, our teachers who are so supportive, many of whom are here this evening, please give them a round of applause. Our own staff, our own band staff, Skip Crabtree, our drill designer, our technical advisor, Ralph Ferriello and Mark Beavers, our assistant directors, Donato Lupacino and Pat D'Amato, our percussion instructor, John D'Amico, our color guard advisor, Trish Thompson, her assistant, Cynthia Whalen. Please give all of them a round of applause. I certainly have to thank all of you for being here, for all of your support, starting back with hot cross buns all the way up through tonight and what will happen on in the spring. I have to thank my department, I was almost remiss there, I apologize, my department, my fine arts department here at the high school for all of their support, and our visual arts department, Trish Thompson, our color guard advisor, Debbie Sarasi and Rich DiBiase, our theater director, Margie Marr, and our choral director, Phyllis Silver. Please give them a round of applause. To all of our alums who come back time and time again, if you're in the audience, please stand. Welcome home. Thank you. Thank you. And again, to all of you, and to anyone who I may have forgotten to thank, I apologize. You will come to me a second and a half after I walk off stage, and then I'll text you and apologize. Thank you for all your support. Thank you for being here. Enjoy the holiday. Have a happy, healthy, restful holiday season. We hope to see everyone back in the spring. And in keeping with 56 years of tradition, we will close our holiday concert with Irving Berlin's White Christmas. very much, everyone. Have a wonderful holiday, and we'll see you back next year in the spring for our spring concert.